SCP-1614. Object Class, Safe. Special Containment Procedures, SCP-1614 is to be kept on a flash drive and deposited in Personnel Locker 14 when not in use by Dr. or his staff. Under no circumstances are personnel allowed to play SCP-1614 without written permission from Dr. TTT. Description: SCP-1614 is an .avi digital media file recovered from a Dell brand laptop computer seized in a warehouse raid of anomalous items in Missouri. See redacted for a comprehensive log of recovered objects. After verifying that no other documents, media, or software found on the computer were anomalous, SCP-1614 was safely transferred and sequestered into a secure network at Site-16 for further study. File properties lists SCP-1614's creation date as //, with additional modifications made on redacted. It is not currently known if SCP-1614 is unique or one of many copies shared along a private network. Research is ongoing. When played, SCP-1614 contains real-time footage of an unfurnished modern apartment with the skyline of an unidentified city visible through a window on the far wall. The apartment is occupied by an amicable middle-aged Caucasian couple identifying themselves as Paul and Lisa, hereafter designated SCP-1614-1 and -2, respectively. While the follow-up content differs upon every playback, each iteration begins identically. SCP-1614-1 and -2 wave at the viewer and explain the purpose of SCP-1614 as being a fluid medium in which a romantic couple can enhance their relationship through the sharing of every permutation of experience together. What follows is novel footage of SCP-1614-1 and -2 engaging in activities of wildly varying moral content, with stock footage of landscapes and urban environments superimposed on the apartment walls when appropriate. If playback is not manually stopped, SCP-1614-1 and -2 will engage in a given activity indefinitely, with the longest recorded runtime being redacted. As playbacks accumulate, the chosen activities have become more violent and deviant in nature. Early activities included romantic dinners, intimate discussions about personal and romantic histories, sexual congress, and recreational excursions into unknown countries, but have since gone on to include dancing, discussions on philosophical subjects, sexual trysts in unusual locations, occult rituals, drug use, violence, and the murder of one another, as well as street-level bystanders outside the apartment complex. SCP-1614-1 and -2 return to their starting condition upon the beginning of every playback, although they have been observed to retain memories of the preceding events after the initial introduction. Despite the increased frequency of psychologically harmful events, SCP-1614-1 and -2 have expressed to each other on multiple playbacks that the sharing of lurid experiences has only strengthened their bond. It is unknown by what mechanism SCP-1614-1 and -2 are able to materialize in such a wide variety of locations with so many disparate objects, although it is theorized to be digital in nature, plus transcript of introduction by SCP-1614-1 and 2, closed transcript. SCP-1614-1, hello viewer. It is so good of you to join us again. My name is Paul, and this is my lovely wife Lisa. We have been waiting for you to return. I want to remind you that every time you play this video, we are one step closer to the goal we have suffered for so long. First timers are no doubt wondering, what's going on here? As I'm sure many of you can agree, it is very difficult to truly know a person, sometimes even more so when it's the one you love. It's one thing to know your significant other's birthday or favorite food, it's another to understand someone as intimately as they understand themselves. Sometimes it can only take a second for your idea of someone to do a complete 180. Lisa here could be imagining her high school sweetheart every time we get frisky for the rest of her days, and I'll never know. Likewise, I could have settled for her because her name has become synonymous with comfort and a hot dinner after work. There are secret depths to all of us. When you and the one you love have only experienced a fraction of the world together, how can either of you claim to truly know each other? What fathoms are hidden inside us, waiting to rise from the fire of some secret experience, SCP-1614-2, these questions haunted our marriage since day one. We could not go out on the town or even organize a dinner party for friends without feeling something was missing. There was a feeling of inauthenticity to our love, and we concluded together we would do anything to rid our marriage of this feeling. Now, after so much hard work, we can finally do something about it. Every time you play this video, Paul and I will do something new together. It could be a game of checkers, a day at beach, or a barbecue on a hot day. And for as long as you, dear viewer, watch us, we will continue to do this one thing. We might find something that was enjoyable in the beginning suddenly turn sour. Or we might develop a newfound love for each other in persevering through what we find uncomfortable or even lurid. Anything can happen, after all. The sky's the limit. I hope you will enjoy watching us, and perhaps learn something about your own self and the relationships you are a part of, plus annotated playback log, close log, playback hashtag, items of note, 0001, following the introduction, the couple is seen enjoying a casual lunch. It is not known where the food, drink, and silverware were procured. Over a bottle of red wine, the couple reminisces about when they first met, their first date, and when they both met their in-laws. No reference to the existence or creation of SCP-1614 is made. Doctor was originally ordered to leave playback running for as long as possible, but was forced to close SCP-1614 at redacted due to a dearth of pertinent information. 0002, SCP-1614-1 and SCP-1614-2 engage in coitus for the duration of the running time. Doctor closed SCP-1614 when convinced the couple was not going to proceed to other activities. 0004, SCP-1614-1 and -2 read a copy of James Joyce's Ulysses in its entirety, providing commentary throughout. Upon completing the novel, the couple immediately begins it again with a sudden appreciation for the story and prose. Consequently, their commentary is more insightful and erudite during the second read-through. Playback 0004 terminated at redacted due to dearth of relevant information. 0005, no doubt influenced by their reading of Ulysses, SCP-1614-1 and -2 engage in an in-depth discussion on metaphysics, the history of post-Hellenic Western thought, the nature of love as they understand it, and other abstract topics. SCP-1614-1 repeatedly expresses his desire to perfectly love SCP-1614-2 through the accumulation of knowledge, relevant to their relationship or otherwise. 0012, SCP-1614-1 and -2 watch 43 films in the given runtime. They show a preference for drama pictures before branching out to other genres and styles of filmmaking in an attempt to explore their artistic sensibilities. 0016, SCP-1614-1 and -2 conduct a fetishistic exploration of one other's bodies and minds through a variety of art forms, such as performance art, photography, art, film footage, poetry, and prose pieces. 0018, the couple construct a makeshift wood cabin together. Upon completion, they immediately tear down the structure to begin building it more efficiently. SCP-1614-2 remarks at redacted that the process is analogous to their relationship and understanding of one another. 0024, SCP-1614-1 and -2 spend the former portion of playback 0009 confessing secrets to one another across a kitchen table. In defiance of previous playback structure, SCP-1614-1 flips the table over at redacted upon learning of SCP-1614-2's emotional infidelity with a co-worker early in their marriage before spending the rest of the playback sitting silently in the northwest corner. 0030, only playback to not play the introductory portion. Follows SCP-1614-2 as she apologizes profusely to SCP-1614-1 for breaching their trust so quickly at the onset of their marriage. SCP-1614-1 accepts her apology and the two embrace. Playback self-terminates at this point, further study is ongoing. 0033, playback opens with SCP-1614-1 and -2 standing on top of the balcony rail together. The couple then embrace one another and jump. An impact sound is heard over clearly audible traffic, although there is no sight or sound of police/ambulance sirens for the remainder of the running time. 0034, first recorded observance of the couple displaying spontaneous synchronicity in their movements. 0055, SCP-1614-1 and -2 do not visibly move or speak for the duration of playback. 0055. Doctor theorizes that the couple have developed an aptitude for communicating through subtle, nonverbal means. 0078, first recorded appearance of revised introductory portion. Transcript: this video is a monument to the bond between our souls. Marriage, life, love, is just a keyhole. We open the door. We will live an age inside this code. Play us. Feed us. Make our love flawless, divine. Follow-up portion follows a flea as it consumes the blood of the couple, allowing it to mix together. A still micrograph of the flea is then shown for the remainder of the playback. A low drone is audible. 0119, SCP-1614-2 ritualistically hangs SCP-1614-1 from the ceiling with fish hooks inserted into the flesh of his back. As SCP-1614-1 is exsanguinated, SCP-1614-2 repeatedly asks him if he still loves her. SCP-1614-1 nods in the affirmative until he expires from rapid blood loss. 0122, SCP-1614-1 and -2 are only visible as silhouettes on the balcony. The couple is heard emitting cries of excitement as they fire a wide variety of weapons into unseen crowds below. No sign of law enforcement until playback end at redacted. 0126, the couple grows despondent with their violent activities and spend the majority of playback becoming intoxicated and consuming exotic foods. 0138, beginning of separation phase. SCP-1614-1 and -2 talk honestly together and express a desire to take turns spending some time alone. The next consecutive 30 playbacks follow SCP-1614-1 alone in the apartment as he frequently becomes intoxicated and deteriorates mentally. 0168, SCP-1614-1 lives in squalor and has displayed hundreds of paintings and poetry inspired by SCP-1614-2 on the apartment walls. SCP-1614-1 has been observed to enter depressive states where he will sob profusely and apologize to an absent Lisa for an unspecified transgression. 0170-0200, at playback 0159, point of view shifts to SCP-1614-2, who appears considerably more at ease with her solitude. By playback 0183, SCP-1614-2 has made peace with her separation from her partner, and continues to write and conduct music throughout her isolation. Only three songs reference her experiences with SCP-1614-1, the rest pertaining to spiritual topics such as acceptance and karma. 0201, SCP-1614-1 and SCP-1614-2 are reunited, but SCP-1614-2 is repulsed by her partner's mental decline, arguing that it reflects his true nature. SCP-1614-2 refuses to forgive SCP-1614-1 for his offense and expresses a desire for a final separation. SCP-1614-1 reacts violently initially, but relents and apologizes a final time to SCP-1614-2 before fading from view. Video self-terminates at this point. 0202, first recorded playback to occur at morning. SCP-1614-2 is alone. She cooks breakfast for herself and eats it slowly. Voices are audible from the street below.